get, the better off emotionally we tend to be generally.
Oh, yeah.
And here's the surprise. That research shows that older people seem to have retained those emotional resilience factors.
Oh, yeah.
Even during a global pandemic that was especially deadly for the elderly.
It was.
So today,
that's why I'm heading to a crowded bar.
Good news about aging and what we can all learn from.
So I can go do some super spreading.
And I'm joined today by Laura Carstensen, professor in public policy and professor of psychology at Stanford University, founding director of the Stanford Center on Longevity. She was also lead researcher of the study that was the impetus for this hour. Laura, welcome to On Point.
Hi, Magda. Nice to be with you.
Yes. I want to state, first of all, clearly that this is not going to be a simplistic discussion, right? We're going to talk about all the complexities that come with aging in every culture, but especially in the United States. But let us start with the good news.
Like vertigo.
What exactly did your research find about emotional resilience amongst people over 50, even in the middle of the pandemic?
We found that older people
fucking alcohol got them through.
Negative emotions in their lives and more positive emotions than younger people did.
Mm-hmm.
And this was a gradual...
Can't imagine why.
Starting from... I'm
sure a lot of 20-somethings have a lot of positive emotions.
People, the older they were reporting on balance better emotional experience.
And how did you measure that? And what exactly were they reporting? What did you ask them?
We asked them...
They made it to the bathroom without shitting their pants.
Emotions. So some emotions positive and some were negative. Emotions like joy,
joy.
Anger, frustration.
Well, there you go.
So they gave us ratings on each of those, and what we saw were
anger and frustration.
The negative ones were reported less frequently and less intensely, and the positive ones more so with age.
And when you say frequently, is this something that you checked with people throughout the pandemic, over time?
This was one survey, but we have used this approach in many of our studies over the years with the same emotions that we asked them about. And then some of those studies, we use an approach called experience sampling, where people are alerted at random times during the day, and we say, right now, how angry are you? How frustrated? How calm? And so,
well, I just shit my pants, so I'm pretty angry and frustrated. But as soon as I change my diapers, my positive fucking outlook ought to improve.
Just let me confirm something. The survey that you did was relatively early in the pandemic. Could it?
At 8 o'clock in the morning.
In April, yes. So it was right at the time when there was tremendous uncertainty. It was clear that something terrible was happening.
Yes, very clear. I couldn't...
Okay.
Goddamn value of my house.
Confounding factors here. that might make the conclusion maybe a little more or less clear, because I wonder... Now, on the one hand, early in the pandemic, that April period, everything was shutting down, right? So in a sense, we were all... in this, you know, in the first grip of that uncertainty, as you're talking about. And we also have the beginnings of evidence of the particular deadliness of the pandemic for the elderly. Those things are true,
deadliness.
I frame this as people maybe able to maintain their emotional resilience even in the pandemic. Do we yet know if there's a durability to that emotional resilience across the year we've all collectively experienced?
Yeah, it looks like there is. There were other studies using different approaches, but asking the same kinds of questions that were published since our paper.
How fucked are you?
Same thing. And finding it in other countries as well. So it wasn't just a reflection of one particular snapshot during this period. One other thing, we decided that we should also survey some people who may not be living in the community, who might have been in frailer health, and so since
the original
study was published,
what
that
is
you and
trailer
I were
health?
About, we also surveyed a large number of people who live in assisted living. Same pattern.
Really?
Same pattern we were seeing as in the community.
Wow, okay. So here's where I want to just... Because aging in America or everywhere in the world, it's
it sucks.
differentiated experience.
It
right,
fucking sucks. There's nothing highly differentiated about it. Fucking sucks across the goddamn board.
And, like, we're already getting feedback from listeners, and this, I expected this. This is from Kaya. Kaya? I'm sorry if I said your name wrong, but trying here. Who says, whenever I see stuff like this, I think about the lack of intersectionality in these discussions. A lifetime of racism, sexism, ableism, heterosexism, classism, everything paints a different
picture. Heterosexism.
So,
there you
I mean,
go.
How did you
classism.
For that? And I would also say income inequality. How did you factor for that in your study?
That's a really good point to raise. And there clearly is heterogeneity in the older population in well-being. Some people are doing better than others.
Some people are more fucked than other people.
Than younger people. That's what I mean. So it isn't the fact that there aren't older people who are struggling.
Yeah, because they're going to fucking die first. Get out of this goddamn nightmare.
We're the same kind of
fucking young people starting to pull their fucking heads out of their fucking asses about how fucked they are.
But on average, people seem to be getting better. And in our research, we have looked very closely at socioeconomic status, race, and we find similar kinds of effects across those different segments of society. I should note that we have not studied, and very few people do study, people living in extreme poverty. So we don't know about that group.
No, we don't.
A cross-section of Americans, some much wealthier, better educated than others, and we still see the similar kinds of patterns.
So I'm hoping that maybe a postdoc in your group somewhere might think, aha, there's an important area of research and knowledge we need to generate as a nation about understanding better
how fucked we are
for Americans living in extreme poverty. So let's listen for a second. We've got a lot of feedback from listeners about this topic. And so this is James Nave from outside Taos, New Mexico.
Okay, James.
James told us this about the wisdom he says he's gained.
Yes.
The pandemic has allowed me, at least, to say goodbye to all the trappings and simply be with myself. And I think when we're over 50 and we arrive at a situation like that, at a time like that, we may be suited enough to accommodate it because we have a sense of self that has emerged or is emerging
that we're fucked.
Does not require the validation of the external.
No, we can internally know how fucked we are every time we fucking get up in the morning. Goddamn can't get out of fucking bed without passing out from vertigo.
Reflected in that comment also is the richness of the emotional experience. I sometimes fear that.
How about the extreme poverty of the emotional experience?
Lines, like older people are happy. Older people are happier than young people. You get this kind of happy-go-lucky.
The happy-go-lucky.
And that's not what the research shows. Older people have more mixed emotions. They're more likely to experience joy with a tear in the eye than younger people are. We see a kind of a savoring.
It's called jerking off. Joy with a tear in the eye.
That's what captures the emotional experience. It is not.
All right, we got a monster truck being dragged by a monster truck. All right, we got live music. All right, we got a Hummer. We got a Hummer being dragged by a monster truck.
There are two.
Shut the fuck up. All right, we got some live music here. At this super spreader event. All right. Johnny Cash. We got Johnny Cash going on here in the super spreader event of this Oasis of Freedom. A little bit of Johnny Cash. Hell yeah. All right. Look at this super spreader. Oh, Jesus, man. You can't even get in the place. Let's see if there's a place to park. Yes, here in the Oasis of Freedom. This is your old fart. All right, do I steal this fucking electric car charger parking space? Jesus. All right, is this a fucking parking place? All right, I'm gonna block the drive-through window of the bank. All right. I have my choice of super spreader events. I'm going to take my negative old man emotions and get positive. All right. I got to put my little dog in his winter jacket. You got to stay here a while because I'm going to go to a super spreader event. Maybe listen to some Johnny Cash. Bye, guys.